Here's a rundown of the possible tools that you could use. And I have a cover right here that pops off that goes into my dash. Today's episode of McFucker's Garage. I'm gonna take this jack and this jack to make one working jack. Stay tuned. So this jack right here is a 2-ton jack. The handle is broken off, but it's got a swivel head. I actually like that. There's plenty of oil in it. It's still a good jack. It's just the cotter pins snapped on me a while back ago, and I just haven't had the time to fix it. So today, I had some spare time. I was going to work on the Crown Vic, but this jack is out of oil. It won't jack enough to hold the car up. So instead of taking the oil from that jack, I'm going to take this jack, and I'm going to take its cotter pins, and I'm going to put them into this handle. This jack does not swivel, but it is good to have these two jacks. But because I don't have any oil, and I don't have any money to go get oil right now, I'm going to just swap these around. First, I'm going to start by removing these little cotter pins right here. They should just pop off. I'm going to need to save them and reuse them. That's one. We'll play it right there. And then we can slide this little pin out. And looks like it should work. Looks about the same, huh? Okay, now we got another cotter pin right here. Just pops off very easy. See? Put it with the other one. Alright, now we're gonna pull this guy out. He's a little rusty. Hopefully we can get him out. Well, it looks like I have two options, and I don't want to do either of them. I can take my angle grinder, and I can just cut off this little piece of hipty-hoo right here, and slide this pin out. Or I can pop this out, and then hopefully the whole jack will come apart. It looks like it was supposed to be welded, but as you can see, the whole assembly wiggles. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I've decided the easiest way to go about this is to just find another pin that will go through that hole, and I'll reuse that pin right there, and I just need to pop this thing off. I'll probably have to take it to my vise, which is right over there. Alright. I'm going to need to open it up. Let's see, what weapon of destruction shall I use? Use the pliers! Spread it open! What? Sure thing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take this and use it like a wedge, and I'm going to drive it in there with a mallet. And it should spread it open. Alright. Doesn't need to be open much. And voila. Okay, now I'm going to attempt to put this on here. It looks like it works. And now I will need something to squeeze it. These channel lock pliers should do the trick. Yeah, you want it to go right on the edge there, so it grabs the jack. Alright. Like I said before, I'll probably need another one of these. I think I might have one lying around in my miscellaneous odds and ends. Alright, so this little pin is supposed to rest in here. That's what makes the jack piston go up and down when you jack it. So you put that on there, and you line the hole up with that little seating point, and you push it through there. And then you take your cotter pin. I don't know if you can see that hole. There's a wee little hole. And you stick this cotter pin to this cotter pin. And that locks it in place. But what about this side, you may ask? Well, like I said before, I'm going to have to find something to shove in there. I might be able to just get away with a bolt. Alright, so here's my miscellaneous assortment of odds and ends drawer. I have a bucket of odds and ends that I keep sweeping off the floor that I still haven't gone through. But we might be able to find something to work in here. Hey, who left this wing nut in charge? Ha ha! I got a wing nut and a refrigerator leg. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, will it fit? First try. I'm really good at eyeballing these things. That's all I really need on it. There we go. And it clears. Look at that. Let's see if I can jack it. That's not the right head for it. Oh. I haven't used this jack in probably 3 years. Here's the arm for it. The right arm. Something's wrong here. Ugh. I can't jack it. It's not working. Maybe if I hit it a little. Oh, that smells like burning electricity. Give it a little penetrating oil. Maybe I don't have enough weight on it, I don't know. What could be the problem? Uh-huh. Look down inside there. See all that brown sludge? That just came out from after I sprayed the penetrating oil. After not using it for a while, it had rusted. Hopefully I can free it. Hopefully. Yep, there she goes. Just being a bitch. Probably needs to be jacked a couple of times. Well, we're bending our little mounting bracket. That's not good. Look at that. Bent the piss out of her. I may have to just work this piston up and down a little bit until it works again. I might be able to take the piston off the other jack too, seeing how that one does work. Yeah, look at that. Rusty. I hope the inside is okay. I still hope it jacks. Well, it's going up as I do this, so that's a good sign. Yeah. She's jacking. This jack's gonna come in handy. Oh, there's the piston. It's a different piston from the other one, so I gotta stay with it. I'm gonna clean it up with some sandpaper. I'll be right back. Oh, I don't have any sandpaper, so I'm just gonna wire brush it a little. Can't believe that shit. Can you? How many people out there would have just gone out and bought a new one? Answer me that. Comment below. Alright. We're jacking it as we hit it. Ow, fuck you. I should probably do this in the vise. Alright, so hopefully I can just squeeze it back together and I don't have to hit it. Put my finger in there to sturdy it. Now this thing's becoming a big giant spring. It's gonna get spring loaded here. So we gotta be careful. She wants to pop out and poke me in the eyeball. Alright, that should do it. Alright, now I'm gonna try to tap it in place. Okay, that's not working. put it on its side and do it. So where there's a will, there's a way. The force is strong with this one. Don't generally give up if I can avoid it. I think the easiest way will probably be to open it up. Son of a bitch.
Man hands. Fuck.
Okay, she's on. I'll pinch it with the vice grips. Maybe I'll give her a little more. There we go. We don't want that coming off now. Okay, now let's reassemble. Pin. Where's the refrigerator leg? There it is. Would you like a turkey leg? No, I would like a refrigerator leg, my good sir. Indeed. Would you like a wing nut to go with that too? Why, yes. I would prefer to have a wing nut. Exceptionally good, sir. Jolly good. Pip, pip. Bully. Uh-oh. Maybe that's how people used to talk back then. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to jack it. Will it jack? One pump. Two pumps. Three pumps. It's working. Look, Ma, I'm jacking it. Oh, happy day. I really do like this jack. It's got the swivel head. This jack is awesome. Oop, except for when it does that. Oh yeah. It takes a lot of pumps though, but... Yeah, looks like the piston rod actually has a little rust on it too. Okay, we're topped out there. Give a little squirt on the rod. Okay, we'll release it. Oh god, it's stuck. There we go. Okay, we'll give it one more jack. You know, a mechanic friend of mine, when I was first learning, taught me that until you actually have that jacked up underneath your car, it's a good idea to actually jack this by hand without the lever. It goes quicker, and you don't look like a fool. So I should have done that in the first place, but right now it's still taking a lot of force to push that piston down. I'm going to have to jack it a couple of times to make sure all the fluid's going. Work its way up and down and move smoothly. But there you have it. I can jack it again.
And each time I do this, the more it goes up. This is awesome. I haven't used this jack in 2 years. Alright, I'm the Foss Man. Thanks for watching this video. If you'd like to see any other types of videos like this, leave a comment below on what you'd like to see. And if I can afford to do it, I'll see if it can be done. In the meanwhile, you'll have to deal with my random project videos, random drive videos, and my random weekly vlog videos. So, thank you everyone. Thanks for watching. Please remember to leave a like, comment on what you've seen or would like to see, and subscribe to my videos. It will really help me out. I appreciate it. You'll have a good one. Hey, Gracie. You scared Daddy. And you're on.